You hear me, America?
They're just chewing.
How many goddamn pretzel stick around there?
Right here. Just disrespecting you right off the bat. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. You know, us two queers. Just us two backstabbing queers.
Fat faggot, whatever Dan is.
I'm a skinny queef. No, pussy? Pussy, I think.
Boy, did we make some compelling radio yesterday, huh?
Well,
we didn't make it so much as we facilitated it, I suppose.
Well, we watched it. Doug Stanhope and Yamanika Saunders obviously got into it yesterday on the Bonfire, and then this morning in my study, I looked at Twitter.
The internet's been ablaze.
People have accused Jay and I of, this is my favorite thing, of stabbing Doug Stanhope in the back.
You can't stab somebody in the back, by the way, when you're saying things on a very public show. there's also a radio document of everything that was said.
Let the record stay. Ah, oh, man. We're gonna touch on it briefly and then we'll move on. I think it's so funny, the term backstabbing. It's like, you sensitive queef.
Yeah.
Whoever's like, you backstabbed him. No, he didn't. I love, first off, let the record show, and you'll say this, I'm a massive Doug Stanhope fan.
Yeah.
I mean, I said that to you yesterday. I
was like, I'm a big fan and a friend.
Yeah, you know him. But he came in hammered. I think he thought I was an intern.
I'm not sure if he knew quite who Dan was.
Which is fine.
One of my favorite Twitter things, too. He goes, to just blame it all on him being drunk. I'm like, well, he was drunk. And as I said in fairness to him, Doug Stanhope, if nothing else.
Forget
hilarious. Forget poignant, smart, all those things. He's fucking rock and roll, dude.
Yeah, very rock and roll.
And he let me know he was coming in hot. He was coming in hammered. Cruise ship drunk, the term he used.
And by the way, in all of his, what we said yesterday on the show and, you know, what went down with him and Yamanika, the thing I will say, the thing that walked him out of the room, I'm on his side with. That Yamanika was being an asshole and just using volume as opposed to arguing with Doug. But at that point, it was a foregone conclusion. Yamanika didn't want to have a conversation with
Doug. Genuinely don't, I can't confirm or deny. I haven't re-listened to it. I just know where we were there.
But I
can't remember that other than I didn't, that very well could have been the case of how that happened.
I think that's how
she
I
got
took
big,
it.
But if I was listening to the whole thing as knowing there was a powder keg kind of getting ready to pop.
Well, I mean, we've talked about it we talked about it at length yesterday, and it really was one of those things where Doug came in, he was hammered, we were having a good time,
when I reached out to him, I heard him on Stern, I thought it'd be really great, oh, Doug's in town, let's see if we can get him, how long are you in town for? He left today.
Yeah.
I said, well, shit, if you can come in today, come. He said he couldn't. He thought we were in Brooklyn somewhere. He still doesn't really fully, grip the idea that this is a serious exam and not a podcast.
Where's the flunky that can get me ice?
That's going to be the great.
I love owning that.
That's going to be a great drop
that
for
piece.
Future.
It's great.
By the way, it was great when he was, great when he was here.
Well, wait, so when I reached out to him. Mm-hmm. He told me he was hammered. I said, well, he's only in town the one day, and I'd love to have him on the show. We've never had him on the show before. He said lovely things about our show in the past, way early in our thing. He actually gave us a lot of kudos. And I love Doug Stanhope. He's great and super awesome to talk to.
Some of my favorite comedy albums of all time are Doug Stanhope albums. He's in my top 10. I mean, I don't even blink an eye. I could even argue to put him in my top 5.
As someone would say, one of my favorite tweets of the thing was like, Jay, you're a fat faggot and blah, 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 and this, and taking Yamanika's side and stabbing Doug in the back. He goes, Dan Soder rules as per usual.
I didn't see that.
That's my favorite one. I was like, you're preaching to the choir. I mean, no one says Dan Soder rules more than Big Jay Okerson.
Did that come in today?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh,
it
man.
Was so fantastic.
That would have made me laugh, at least.
That's great.
That's great.
Thanks.
Dan Soder rules as per usual.
I would just thumb back the computer screen.
You got it, my friend.
Hey.
I'm not sure what Dan did different than me.
Nothing.
Other than Dan called in the car. We shared an Uber XL on the way up here, balling. And Dan said, he goes, what do you think Yamanika and Doug's thing? You think it's going to be a good chemistry they'll find there?
No.
I said, I don't know. I don't know. But I said, if it goes haywire, it'll be great radio. So all this, and we use the term sycophantic tweeting and all this ridiculous worship of something, bring it on. It's fantastic. Good. That means you're listening and you're engaged in some way. But to be so stupid and short-sighted to not see that we invited Doug in, he was hammered, Yamanika came into that situation. It got awkward. He was definitely.
I mean,
he made jokes at her expense that she didn't know him. It was coming kind of out of the gates.
Well, hold on. The tweets.
Let me finish things. People are going to be like, "You're stabbing Doug in the back." Like, I don't even think some of the stuff he said wasn't, as a listener, joyously funny. Very funny stuff. He's. I mean, he asked Yamanika if she was like a real woman. Like, he asked her a bunch of weird, like, awkward questions that are sort of insulting, and not even sort of, they're insulting. And she doesn't know him, and it was like a weird, right out of the gates thing that happened. And I don't think Doug's a piece of shit. I know Doug very well. He's not a piece of shit. Doug came in drunk. I invited him in drunk, opening the door for something like that to possibly happen. So I hold full fault on that. But I don't think it was fault, because everyone's fine. Everyone's adults.
Well, tell him what Doug texted you.
And Doug texted me today that Bingo had to remind him of everything that happened. He had no idea what even happened yesterday.
But that's where
he was awake for whatever, and that's fine. And Doug will be on the show again next time he's in New York. I would want him to be here.
This woman, the tweet was from Paul. This woman, Yamanika, is an abomination. Moreover, Big J Oakerson completely bitched out. However, Dan Soder rules is per usual. Wow, Paul, I disagree with two-thirds of your tweet. That last part's pretty great.
Dan Soder does rule as usual.
Per usual.
As per usual.
I'm just ruling. Now, what I was going to say is
but I get a lot of people saying that I bitched and backstabbed.
I'll let you talk, but I'm saying the thing is, both of them were assholes. Both of them, it was a two-way street. So to say that, like, we turned our backs on Doug, I understand why Doug got pissed. We were talking about the Me Too thing, and that wasn't even the argument. Then he didn't execute the joke properly. But the part that upset Doug Stanhope, sitting next to him and understanding it, was that Yamanika was too gone to have an argument. That was the third strike. He did the, you know, two blacks coming in, and then she kind of took that. If you saw that where I was sitting, she was like, "All right, motherfucker." And then the second one was, "Are you a real woman?" And she was kind of like, "Who is this dude?" Because Yamanika usually is the loudest presence in the room. Then the third strike was, "Has any guy regretted fucking you?" And the tweets.
No, wait, Dan, it was the name thing. That happened.
And you're getting cunty.
Here's where I'll defend Doug, is when it finally did turn into the argument, and Doug was trying to make the point that he was doing the thing of, the point you said was a good point, if you've ever regretted fucking somebody, both men and women.
By the way, I think that was the point.
That was the point. You could see it being telegraphed from that he was going into that by asking her example, and he was going to try to go around the room and be like, "See everyone."
Maybe. Absolutely. And by the way, I thought the conversation topic was fantastic.
But when Yamanika was just plowing over him with volume, I understand that. That makes me lose my shit. I've screamed at women when they're just like, "No! No, you didn't!" And you're just like, "Let me fucking talk!" And that's where he was. And I watched it because it was standing right here. And then when he got like that, he was like, "Man, fuck this," because he knew he wasn't going to get a word in and there was going to go nowhere. And Doug's a highly intelligent guy. So even when he's fucked up, he's a highly intelligent guy. And he knew it wasn't going to move past that we were just at a block. So he left. So he removed himself.
I don't know if he thought that far ahead on it. And that's fine. I don't even have a problem with that. I think what happened, listen. Let's take the perspective here. Again, I said, like, I love both of them. There's no backstabbing to either one of them. Yamanika is joining us later in the show because there's topics with her that I wanted to get into.
How dare you?
How could you? You're siding with her.
How could you?
If Doug was here today, I would have Doug in for the first hour or for the second hour.
I was really hoping there was a chance that we could have done, like a surprise, like a WWE, like,
"Oh, he comes out here, he's coming out." No, he's back on. I felt super bad for Bingo, who was just kind of like dragged into the awkwardness of that for sure.
But the fact
Doug is a very good dude. He's a great dude, actually. Yeah. From when I was very young in comedy, very, very cool to me. I'm not saying he's a piece of shit. I didn't say he was coming off. I'm saying he was drunk, and so the timing on everything was just off. So what happened with Yamanika, so I'm not arguing, I think the topic he brought up was a good one. Take the and other people have talked to me about this today, you gotta take the perspective. So I'm sitting, it's also in relative to where we're sitting.
Yeah, because I'm on Doug's side.
Doug and Yamanika was sitting next to me. From the time she walked in, it was like a black joke right away, which, by the way, make any joke you want. I don't care. It was weirdly you know what I mean? Like,
but Black Lou brought it up that when you're the only, you know, two black people in the room and a white guy you don't know is like, "Oh, black person," you're kind of like, all right.
Yeah, she had no idea what she was walking into necessarily as far as
Negro?
Yeah.
But she
even you can even
so that Negro? Happened. He asked her if she was a woman. He was calling her lady a bunch.
Hey,
my go-to he never quite is got Dan's nice
name.
Lady.
He never quite got Dan's name right down.
Yeah. I'm just a little upset that the whole situation stopped me from being friends with Blackout.
Nah, yeah, but Blackout took Stanhope. But here's what happened. So by the time it was, are you a real woman?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like questions like that. So take the perspective of this. Someone asked you, and by the way, I can't speak for you. I'll speak myself as a fat person who gets insecure about themselves, stuff like this. So now I would answer the question. If someone says, do you believe someone ever regretted fucking you the next day? I'd say, yeah, probably, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
He answered the question. She said no. Which, I don't know where that was, like, headed necessarily with that, but I like the topic.
Mm-hmm.
Was like, oh shit, like, I never even thought about posing that. Like, guys not wanting to have fucked her. I was curious to ask Christina, I said that yesterday, that same question, if she thought that. When he said no, and then someone goes, whoa, you must be really, you are really unaware then. It's almost like saying, like, you're ugly.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
people don't want to.
People, of course, regret fucking you. And it's just like, it just came off. So it just came off wrong. Doug's not a piece of shit. One, for certain, Doug Stanhope is not a racist. He's not a piece of shit. He's not a horrible guy. He came in drunk. It was, listen, I have plenty of friends who were fantastic people that drunkenly had to go, like, hey man, time to go.
Nate?
Yeah. That was good not to say that. Yeah, I mean, Christine.
Like, oh, goddammit, I didn't mean for it to leak out of my face.
Christine's a fantastic person. She's well, but I mean, drunk, she's been bonkers before, so I'm not. If someone goes, are you blaming the alcohol? Like, no, I'm blaming myself for thinking the blame for it would go on me for allowing it to be a situation where I'm like, well, of course that could happen.
Yeah.
Sure. Of course that could. Stabbing Doug Stanhope is welcome on this show anytime.
Anytime.
But we didn't ask him to leave yesterday. He left whether it was a decision made for this is for the greater good or if he was just kind of like, I don't know, it's not going anywhere. Yamanika was very loud. Again, from my perspective on the thing, I didn't see. I didn't see it being points on either side at that point.
But I was on the side of where I heard Doug starting to get agitated because he was like, no, but the point, and he was like trying to start, and then she was just like mowing over him with volume. And I was on this side of it.
Right.
The point that I made about the whole thing and what Jay said about the insecurity of that is I did believe the question was posed as a stock response where if you ask a woman that question, if she says yes, you go in one direction. If she says no, you go in another direction. Yeah. And I think
maybe.
That he
yeah.
is answering, I think the no and saying you're unaware, I think that's stock and I think it was taken personally because he was drunk, his timing was off, and he really just wasn't in the shape to meet new people.
Yeah.
You know, like we really need to.
That's how I saw socialize my friends. I get them blackout.
Yeah, like
I get them blotto, and then I just go, "Hey, you want to meet? You guys want to meet some work friends?"
Because I thought we were going to go into Monique stuff, and like Yamanika and Doug were just going to like riff on it, and it
me
would
too.
Be fine. So
that was the whole plan.
It, like nobody was planning on having that happen. It was just there. You know, you could see it was a straw that broke the camel's back because when Doug left, Yamanika was like, "Of course, people have regretted dating me. I'm insane."
Yeah, yeah.
It wasn't even about that, really. I think it was just like the straw.
I agree, but we've talked about this enough. But
I thank you,
the
Yamanika will be in today. I thank Doug Stanhope very much for coming on. It was very cool of him to come over.
Yeah, and also
when he could, and he, you know, and he's welcome back on the show anytime. He's a legend. He's a living legend of comedy.
And you said that's on Twitter. You can fucking both people can be an asshole. I don't understand this. You stabbed him in the back. You had the audacity to put a dagger in his heart. Shut up, you fucking nerd.
It's like he's a friend.
What kind of nerd, kind of nerd overanalyzes a small thing? I just love the fucking keyboard warriors who are so tough. By the way, motherfuckers, we're on the road. We meet you. I love when I meet a guy and he's like, just this feeble little fucking wet hand. And he's like, I'm a cucknight 91 on Twitter. And you're like, I'll stomp the shit out of you.
Yeah.
You realize I'm not, like, Jay and I are big dudes.
You told
I'm not
me
saying,
I should be jumped.
Yeah. I will never forget when I first went on ONA years ago and I first headlined Cap City. This fucking guy tweets at me, I'm driving in, you better be funny tonight. And after the show, he comes up to me, and he goes, hey man, I tweeted you before the show. It's just this big, fat, pink piece of shit. And he's with his wife, and I go, why the fuck would you write that? Why the fuck would you write that? You think I want to make you laugh now? Because you did that? And he goes like this, oh, I was just watching flops. I'm sorry, man. I was just trying, you just want to be your friend. And it's like, yeah, how about, you don't, it's not all or nothing. It's not their side or ours. There's context.
Yeah.
And there's layers to conversations. What's so fucked up and where Donald Trump's completely right about the media is that they've made it all fucking you're on that side or this side. It's not how fucking life works, you fucking tards. You gotta talk to people and understand there's different perspectives. I can understand Doug being mad at Yamanika, and I absolutely understand Yamanika being insulted by Doug.
Sure.
Who's a guy she doesn't know. So instead of saying this bullshit about how we fucking stabbed, dude, Doug Stanhope's one of my heroes. You know what it's like to be at your job and your hero doesn't recognize you're standing next to you? It's a kick in the dick.
By the way, he was drunk.
Wasn't being mean. I was actively killing, and he wasn't.
I was
going
to say he
me.
Was. He was just like not. He wasn't even paying attention. That's what I'm saying. He was hammered.
It was almost a drunk character where it's like, you know, in kung fu movies where they do drunken, like drunk monkey or those styles where they like fall into something. That's kind of what he does. He's a kung fu expert. He's a karate kung fu expert, and his style is kung fu.
Yesterday was drunken monkey style.
Yeah, exactly. I get fired up because it's like we love doing this show, and so many of the listeners are great, great people. And when something like this and it reaches out outside of our fan base or whatever, and then people want to question our character.
Oh,
like,
dude, if you don't like the show, if you think turn it off.
By the way,
shit.
I hope most of you are bootlegging this on YouTube. I'm the only one that can say that because I don't have a long term contract. But I'm saying for the best thing for the show, I hope y'all motherfuckers are bootlegging this. But also, like, if you don't like it, you can move the fuck on. I've never expected anyone to like me. Obviously, I have an incessant need to be liked, and that's
sure,
why I,
we all do.
Yeah, we all. Every comic does.
No I said my morning started with people writing back right there. You're a pussy, and you stabbed Doug in the back. And I was kind of like, I was gonna respond.
Captain D, even Captain D has been asked to leave and let back in somewhere. you're a good egg, Captain D.
He's a great egg. No, it's definitely like. I forget what my point was now.
I don't know.
Wrapped up into that thing. It's a, look, Doug Stanhope, there's no backstabbing.
Legend. Yamanika friend, great comic.
Yeah, hilarious.
It's like some Twitter people trying to, like, turn
that's
a friend
that's
on
what
us.
What
you're like, what are you doing?
That's what it was, saying a thing like that, all the stuff on the internet this morning. It starts off so negative where I'm kind of like, I think about, like, hopping on and running back, like, backstab, wait, what are you talking about?
What?
I acknowledge exactly what happened in the room here. Like, I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you're
backstab. Well, they keep going, I kind of want to respond, but I didn't, because I just didn't respond, because, I mean,
well, Jay,
20 minutes into going through Twitter, I was just like, I found myself more just laughing at it, like, every time, like, someone's like,
what
they'll
if
be
I,
like, fat, and then they'll put, like, F, asterisk, 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 like, T, like, fat faggot, but, like, they're blurring at themselves, like, don't kick me off Twitter, though. And they go with all this stuff, and it's like, sure, that's great. My favorite one was, like, Dan rules, though. Like,
I just,
sure, Dan rules. Hey, I agree.
It's great we agree on our favorite tweet.
But I think this is great.
Sometimes it's
listen,
like...
The haters listen, too, and those are the people who write you. Take it in, man. I'll tell you what, for my radio listener dollar... that was great radio yesterday, man.
Oh,
that
dude.
Was intense.
Anytime,
it was uncomfortable.
Anytime I
it
can
was
hang
everything
out
you hope.
And smoke a weed pen and not have to wait tables at a Mexican restaurant in Midtown. I'm
another
cool.
good day.
I'm cool.
That's right. That was a lot of fun. And I said, I thank Doug and Yamanika both
now,
for being here. Yamanika will be back today. Doug Stanhope will be back on here whenever he can.
And
I assure you.
And I'm excited.
Doug Stanhope is never, despite all you're trying, Doug Stanhope and me are not enemies for any reason. I admire him greatly, and he's a friend.
I'm still a fan, and I can't wait to reintroduce myself.
He goes, hey, who was the guy who was here last time? You're like, oh, his name was Mark. I'm Dan. Dan Soder. Yahoo's Mansum.
And he goes, where did we meet? I go, we did a podcast together. Yeah. He goes,
we did a podcast a ways back. All whites.
All whites. Comfortable. I was drinking. I'm cool, man. Smell me.
It is funny that Doug, some of my favorite things, though, the moments, Doug saying, going, he's like, well, I'm not racist. I just came from Anthony Cumia. There's a racist. I'm going to DePaulo, another racist. where's all the sycophants throwing him under the bus for calling everyone else a racist?
I have to go
bagging
to another
everybody.
Podcast with a real racist.
He's so fucking great. That's the thing. Is like,
just saying,
you know how much, you know how much Doug
Stanhope how funny that is.
I've watched that even knowing that was on our show, I'm like, yeah, it's still funny.
Of course. Dude, it was
so
fantastic radio. Listen,
so fucking great.
Ask if you're listening to the radio.
Also, it kind of hurt.
And
when I
Doug
go,
asked Yamanika if she's a real woman after he's already made a black joke and called her lady four times, which she gave her name to him four times.
is funny. That's really fun. That's why, and it's heating up and you feel it and you're like, ah, but if you're like, if, I don't know, if I'm listening, no one's throwing a punch. There was nothing like that was going to happen. So it was great, dude. But you're welcome. Everyone, I'll be a fat faggot all day, but you are welcome.
And also,
for that
it's
compelling. Compelling radio we organized.
I'm also going to be doing meet and greets with both hands up now, because I basically was like, I'm bigger than all you. This guy's going to show up and goes, hey, what's up? I'm the one that tweeted.
Yeah, like, well, you'll never recognize him because his picture is a fucking egg or a dodo bird or a Chinese person wearing a Genghis Khan helmet.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, well, that is fun. I mean, the Photoshop work is second to none. But you know what? We love you all. Who gives a shit? Enjoy. I hope
you
enjoy.
All shut the fuck up. You want a cocktail? You want a cocktail?
I hope he calls me. I can't wait to call people Lady Cunt.
Lady Cunt?
What's that clip?
My go-to is Nice Lady. And you're getting cunty.
Yeah. Dude, I knew exactly what he was talking about, because that is legitimately my trigger when a girl is like, when I've been in an argument with a girlfriend and she just keeps talking and keeps talking and you have like point after point. That's usually the point where I punch walls, because she's just like, I'm into me and you, and you're like, she's like trying to start and you can't get it started. You're like, shut the fuck up and let me talk.
The amount of times Jay said to me, if you don't lower your voice, it's about to get really embarrassing.
That's great. How do you say it?
Just like that, real low key.
Through my teeth, like that. Yeah. If you don't lower your voice, I'm going to embarrass the shit out of all of us.
Judo
flip. I'm about to boost it. No, look, Yamanika got, big and loud for sure. Whatever, you know. And Doug called her a cunt and it went back and forth. I mean, like, I don't know how else to describe this other than gigglingly say to you, you're welcome. That was fantastic radio.
It was such a tornado. I mean, when he was leaving, he's like, all right, Big J, clean this up for me.
Big J, make this okay.
Yeah. Big J, make this okay.
And then we played the fucking, the real music.
I mean,
you are welcome. You're welcome, you twats.
Oh, we're gonna dance to our chairs today.
Oh.
I got my new Bigger McCracken shirt on.
Now I'm the fucking racist.
Big J, make this okay. Doug Stanhope is a legend. Oh, he's forever a legend of the Bonfire now.
Oh, damn right.
That was our first, I believe, official.
And it sucks that Bingo got dragged into anything, because obviously she got dragged into it from the beginning by Doug. We love Bingo.
She's afraid of black people.
You're like, what the fuck, Doug? Why are you trying to rile everyone up?
I mean,
so it does.
You couldn't make a movie scene better than that. To have gone from the second she walked in, he tried. I think everything was an attempt at funny, but with one person not understanding fully what's going, like, why am I walking
literally,
and being insulted immediately?
He said that, and I was just like, oopsie. Like, oh, yeah.
Not me. My mouth started watering.
You want to finally
get weird.
You want to take a break, or you want to jump into this Scott Baio stuff right now?
Let's take a break, and then we'll come back fresh, everyone. Again, you're welcome. We love you. Keep listening, or go fuck yourself. Hey. It don't matter either way. We got to be here 6 p.m. no matter what.
Hey, Paul.
Big shout to Paul.
Hey, my dude, Paul. I'll let you know I'm never going to backtrack on you, bud.
No backsteps.
I only go forward. No reverse on this soda.
We'll be right back, everybody. It's the Bonfire.